Hello friends, welcome to C Sharp Intermediate to Advanced tutorial. Now we are at the final part of the sub-series C Sharp Wanna Draw Combo Box. In this video, we will draw the bounding box. Here you can see the selected item is shown with a blue background and there is a red border around the selected item. So this is the bounding box we are going to draw for the selected item. Okay, this is the title from previous one. Here we are going to do the bounding box. So this is how we progressed with this sub-series. First we learned about the MonoDrawn basics. Next we talked about the example. After that we talked about the draw mode property and we get a glimpse of what is MonoDraw fixed and MonoDraw variable. Then we add some startup code. After that we started handling the draw item handler. First we drawn empty rectangle tiles, and in the next video we started filling the tile with the colors. After that we drawn the text string as well. Now we will proceed with the bounding rectangle. So here we are continuing with the same draw item handler, and here we check draw item state dot selected. This is a enumeration constant, and here we are performing the bitwise AND operation to check a specific bit e dot state, and when it is turned on it means the item is in a selected state. So if it is in a selected state, then we should go ahead with the bounding box rectangle drawing. For example, let's consider the cursor is moving from index location 3 to index location 4. And if you see, the background color is redrawn here in the index location 4 because that's the currently selected item. So now let's consider only this picture. The event get fired for item number 3, I mean the draw item handler, as well as for item number 4. So it got fired for item number 3. Why? Because the state is changing from selected to unselected. Since the state is changing from selected to unselected, the background is reset to white. That means previously it is in selected state, the color was in blue. Now it will be redrawn with the white background, and blue background goes to the currently selected item, that means 4. So this is the default behavior, and on top of this we want to draw a red border. And if you see, previously the red border was drawn on item number 3 using its bounds. Now here we are drawing it for item number 4. That means for the previous item we will draw a white rectangle that will erase the content. After that we will draw the red one. So that's what we are here we are doing. When item is in selected state, we will draw a red rectangle. And here GRP is the graphic object associated to this drop down menu, and we are making call to draw rectangle, and pen we are supplying the red color pen. Here we are not filling anything, we are just drawing the outline drawing, and we are performing the rectangle drawing here. And the color we use for the pen is red, and we are making use of e dot bounds. And if you see in here, the entire item is drawn with the e dot bounds. So this is the reason why when we are drawing the tiles, we used the fixed width of 20. We doesn't use e dot bounds dot width, right? For height we used whatever the bounds is giving, but for width we used 20. So here e dot bounds we are using, why? Because we just want to use same width and height whatever this bounds is giving. So using that we drawn the red color rectangle. This is for currently selected item. And in the else portion, we are doing the same draw rectangle, and this is for previously selected item. Right. And if you see, since a draw item is called for two times, so the event will fired in this order. First it get fired for the deselected item, next it will fire for the selected item. So that means we will land up here on the first call. So we erase this red bounding box, and next time it get fired for the newly selected item, and we draw the red color bounding box. So that way, when you move the mouse cursor, it looks like the red border is moving along with the background of blue. All right, now we will go ahead and implement this code change, and we will conclude this sub-series. So the code was already explained in the slide, so we will directly add the bounding box drawing, and now we will run it. So let me press the down arrow key, and you can see the bounding rectangle is drawn in red color, and when I move, the bounding rectangle also moves to show the currently selected item. So I can even directly enter the mouse cursor to a specific item. Right. All right. That's all the demo here. So now we are done with the owner drawn combo box. The same thing you can try with list box and other owner drawn supported control. That's all here in this video. So just now we implemented and completed our owner drawn combo box to show color tile as well as the color. This will help the user to pick a color, and while picking the color itself, they know what exactly the color looks when it is applied on the target medium. Target medium means whether it can be applied to a background or foreground of a text, or wherever the color is need to be applied. And before applying the color itself, based on the tile, user can know what color they are picking actually. Yeah. That's all here. Thank you.